All right, hello everybody, and welcome back to another Deepvue tutorial. This will be a great one, especially for traders who are just starting out with Deepvue, setting up their charting layout, and want to save some time and frustration when setting up their moving averages that they use on different timeframes, from monthly all the way down to intraday. Today we'll be talking about the Deepvue Key Moving Averages indicator, which allows you to set the time frame, the period, the colors, how they show up, all your different moving averages, all in one convenient indicator. So you can see here in this layout, I've got three moving averages here, but you can actually combine everything all in one, and that's what we'll show you today with the Key Moving Averages indicator. And if you do find this tutorial helpful, please go ahead and leave a like down below, subscribe if you're new to the channel. And if you haven't yet taken advantage of the special 2 months for $39 intro offer for Deepvue, highly recommend checking it out. You can click the link down below in the description or popping up right now. With that said, let's go ahead and dive right in. And you can see, as I mentioned, I've got three different individual indicators here that I had to set up, you know, each individually. And this is for my daily time frame. So now if I switch over to a 65 minute time frame and I wanted, you know, different moving averages there, I would have to kind of change them. I would have to go in here, you know, adjust the period, think about the mental math, you know, what is a 50 SMA on a daily chart, converted over to a 65 minute chart. It's just kind of a lot of hassle. And if I have to do that repeatedly, it just takes a lot of time out of my day when I could be executing trades, analyzing charts, or doing other productive things. The good thing is in Deepvue, we've kind of set up a special indicator to kind of address this issue. And that's where the Deepvue Key Moving Averages indicator comes in. So to add it, as with all indicators, you want to click this icon here, type in DV to find all the Deepvue specific ones, and then select the Deepvue Key Moving Averages indicator right here. Loading that onto the chart, you can see we added a lot of moving averages right here. Don't worry if these aren't the final ones that you want to use. You're fully able to customize this to your personal preferences, take away indicators if you only want two, and of course adjust the periods of each of them. So we don't need my previous moving averages, so we'll go ahead and delete those. And all that remains is the Key Moving Averages indicator. To edit the moving averages, what you want to do is hover over that indicator here in the object tree. And if it's hidden right here, you just want to click this drop-down menu. And then we want to go over to the settings gear icon. Clicking this, it brings up the options for this indicator. You can set your intraday moving averages. You can set your daily, weekly, as well as monthly moving averages all in one convenient place. So let's go ahead and set my daily. I like having a 10 EMA. My other one, I want to be a 21, but also an EMA. And I want to have a 50 SMA, which is already set there for me. So there we go. In just a few clicks, I've got what I want. On the weekly, the 10 and 40 is good. And on a monthly, that's good as well. On an intraday, I have to do a little bit of mental math, because say I like to use a 65 minute time frame a lot. What I have to think about is how many bars are on a 65 minute time frame, and in one day, and the answer is 6 bars, and there are 390 minutes in a day. So what is 390 divided by 6? And let's go ahead and do that math, and that is 65. That's how you get the 65 minute time frame. And since there are 6 bars, what I want to do, if I want to show the daily 21 EMA on my intraday chart and have it be kind of the same reference value, I have to multiply 21 by the number of bars. So I would do 21 times 6, which I won't trust my mental math right here. 21 times 6 is 126. So I want to set up a 126 period EMA, and we'll just kind of leave it at that. That'll be my sole intraday moving average. The next step is to set up the styling for all the different moving averages that you have. So let's go over here, and you want to remember that you set up the intraday MA2, and we'll go ahead and make that a nice purple color. We'll go ahead and increase the opacity and increase the thickness right there. And let's actually make that one less thick. In terms of my daily moving averages, we've got MA2, 4, and 5. So let's go ahead and adjust this MA2 to a nice blue color. We'll do the 21 EMA in that same purple color, but let's go ahead and increase the opacity there. That's a good thickness. And then the 50 SMA, I like to put as a red color there. So you can see the colors changing in the background. And for the weekly chart, we've got the MA1 and MA4 active, 10 and 40. So let's go ahead and change that styling. And that was the MA1 and 4 on a weekly time frame. So let's scroll down here to weekly. Let's make this one red, increase the opacity. And 4, let's go ahead and make that black and again increase the opacity. So that's pretty much set up. We've got the inputs ready on both an intraday, daily, as well as weekly time frame. You can adjust the monthly, of course, as well here. And we want it to be visible on all these different time frames. So that's pretty much set. So once we've got those set up like we would like, we'll press OK. And now you've got all your indicators, all your moving averages, all in just this one indicator, which you can hide if you would like to. And if we go over to a 65 minute time frame, we'll see that 21 EMA standing alone. There you go. So you can see it's right around 875. And if we go back to the daily time frame, that will be where the 21 EMA is, right around that area. And if we go over to a weekly time frame, you'll see that we've got the 10 and 40 week setup. So that's all being accomplished by this one moving average. And again, to find that, you want to click indicators, type in DV, and you can either search that more or just click key moving averages right there. So this is just a really handy indicator that allows you to set everything up, you know, consolidate a lot of your indicators all in one, and just kind of make your life easier when you're first getting used to the platform. So thanks so much for watching. Remember to do that mental math right. If you're setting up your intraday moving averages, for instance, if you want a 50 SMA on a 65 minute time frame, you'd multiply 50 times 6, which would be a 300 period moving average on the 65 minute time frame. And if you want to set things up on a 15 minute chart, you can just basically divide 390, which is the total number of minutes in a day, by 15, get that number of bars that show up each day, and multiply that number by the 21 EMA or the 50 SMA to get the equivalent on that particular time frame. But anyways, I hope this helped you guys out. Let us know your feedback down below. Subscribe if you're new to the channel. Leave a like down below, as well as any suggestions that you have for future tutorials. And I'll see you guys in future videos. Take care.